Hello students, this is Neha Mathur and today I will tell you how to solve numericals based on K-map. Since the complete detail of the K-map concept I already covered in my last two lectures, so you can get the complete detailing of the concept by following last two lectures of K-map, in which you can know how to K-map structure is drawn and how to go with the grouping of the equation. So today I will start with numericals directly. But before starting the video, consider to subscribe my channel by click on bell icon to get updated for the upcoming videos. So now I will start the numericals just to get the optimized equation, because the K-map is basically used to get simplified or more optimized Boolean equation. So I will start with the numericals. The first numerical, the equation, as I told you in the concept of K-map, that the input information before starting the question may be given in the form of truth table, sum of product or product of sum. So let's see what is first question actually. The question is a logical expression. Logical expression, or you can say Boolean equation, or you can say Boolean equation, Boolean expression, logical equation, logical expression. Simply, the equation is given as follows. The equation looks like this. So the question is, y is equals to a bar b bar c bar plus a bar b c bar plus a bar bc plus a b bar c. This is the equation. Now what we have to do, the question is saying that minimize it using K map. This is the complete question, that one equation is given to you and you will have to minimize this equation by using the concept of K-map. Why? One thing come into mind is that why here it is mentioning K-map? Because you have one more method to solve such kind of equation, that was manual method, or by following the concept of Boolean algebra, there was some 10 to 11 laws. By using that laws, you can also solve such kind of equation. But that is not more efficient method, because the equation you will get after applying Boolean law might be optimized or might not, but the equation you will get by following the concept of K-map, it will be totally optimized and more simplified equation. That's why K-map is most preferred instead of manual method. Now start the solution. See, first thing is, first you should observe the equation actually. The equation which simply you can observe that here you have three variables. Just by observing the equation, you can find that here you have three variables represented by A, B and C. So since we want to solve this equation using the concept of K-map, so you have the structure of the K-map, and the structure of the K-map depends on the number of variables. Here you have three variables, that means you will have 2 raised to the power 3, that is 8. So the structure will look like this, having 8 number of cells like this. So just by observing the number of variables, since here I have 3 variables, that means 2 raised to the power 3, that is 8. The structure will have total 8 number of variables. Fine. Now the what is the next? The next is, you have to represent number of variables, 2 variables here and third variable is here. Now about the numbering of the cells, that is, the first cell is 00, 01, 1110 by following the concept of gray code. Similarly, for the one variable, the binary number may be 0 or 1. Fine. This is the general structure you will have to draw before starting the approach of the solution. This is the general structure. Once you get the number of variables, you can draw this. Now the next thing is, see, it will be fine for you if you will represent individual variable for individual binary number. How? See, 0, 0, that means A is equals to 0 and B is equals to 0. And for the SOP kind of form, you may write here A bar, B bar for these two numbers, because 0 is always represented by complement form while 1 is represented directly. Similarly, A and B, so it will like A bar B, A B, that means A B bar, A B bar. Similarly, for the C, since this is a 0, so it will be C bar, and this is 1, so it will be C. This is the general structure of K-map for 3 variables. Now back to question, what is mentioning in the question? Here you have 4 terms, first, second, third and fourth. The one more thing is, since it is a SOP form and individual term of the equation is said to be min term, as I already told you, fine. So by following this equation, you will have to mark 1 in this structure. How you will do? See, the first term is A bar, B bar, C bar. That means A bar, B bar, C bar. So to represent the first term in the K map, you will have to write 1 here. Similarly, back to the next term, which is A bar, B, C bar. A bar, B and C bar. So the 1 will come here. Next 1 will come here. What about the next? It is A bar, B, C. A bar, B, C. So it will be here. And the fourth term is A, B bar, C. That means A, B bar, C. So it will be here. Fine. Since you have 4 terms in the equation, that means you fill 4 times number of 1s in the structure. Now, after filling the number of 1s in the K map, the next step is the grouping of the number of 1s. Is it possible to make a grouping? Grouping in terms of pair, quad and octet. And if you remember, if you are remembering the concept of K-map, then instead of making pair, I will prefer quad, and instead of making quad, I will go with octet. So if you have the possibility of making octet, then try to avoid quad and pair. Similarly, if it is possible to make a quad, then try to avoid pair. Just I can conclude the complete conclusion in one line. That means more number of grouping or more number of cells merging is preferred instead of making small group. Now just observe, is it possible to make any octet? No, this is not possible, because in octet we must have at least 8 number of cells having 1. Here I have only 4 ones, so it is not possible to make an octet. Now back to quad. Since the 4 cells having there is a possibility to make a octet having 4 adjacent cell. This is not possible to make a quad. Now what about pairing? I can directly observe that by grouping these 2 cells, I can make a 1 pair. Similarly, by grouping these 2 cells, I can make another pair. So here I have possibility to make a group of 2 pair. This is pair 1 and this is pair 2. What about this one? It is not possible to make a pair of this one with another one, because this is not adjacent with any of the cell given in the structure. Now once you are clear by grouping of pair or quad or octet, the next term is the elimination of the variable. Now how it happens? See, start to write complete expression for individual term. For this pair, that is pair 1, I have two ones, this one and this one. Now write, firstly write the expression for this one, that is A bar, B bar, C bar. A bar, B bar and C bar. Now write the expression for the next term of this pair, that is A bar, B and C bar. Fine. These are the two terms for both these terms of pair 1. Now, once we come for the elimination of the variable, always remember the variable which is changing from first to second term will eliminate in this step. See, A bar, B bar, so it will not eliminate. Similarly, C bar and C bar, it will also be not eliminate. But B bar, then B. So this B can be eliminated. Now you will have only A bar and C bar. So the first pair is giving one term, which is A bar, C bar. Now come to pair 2. Again, you will have to write the terms for both the cells of pair 2. For pair 2, I have first cell and the term for the first cell is A bar, B, C bar. Similarly, for this, I have the term A bar, B, C. Now again, the same rule, that is, if it is possible the variable is changing in its own term, then you can eliminate that variables. See, A bar, no chances of elimination. Similarly, B, B, there is no chance. But in case of C, here I have C bar while here C. So C can be eliminated. Now you have the term A bar, B for the pair 2. What about this single one? There is no chance of making a group for this one. So I will write directly the term for this A, that is A, B bar and C. So after make a grouping of these number of ones, now you have three terms. So now the reduced equation will be A bar, C bar from here plus A bar B plus A B bar C. Now this is the minimized equation of this Boolean equation. You can see the difference in the given question. You have four terms, 1, 2, 3, 4. While you go by solving this equation using K-map, now you have optimized equation in which you have only three terms, 1, 2, 3, and instead of three variables, for first two terms you have only two variables. So you can easily see the difference between this simplified equation and this given equation. So this is the method to solve any Boolean equation by using K-map. I am again repeating the steps. The first step is try to observe the number of variables. Once you are clear with the number of variables, then it will be easy to make a rough structure of a K-map having how many number of cells. If you have two variables, that means the K-map structure will have total four cells. If you have three variables, then the K-map structure will be in the form of 8 cells, while for the 4 variable it will be in the form of 16 cells. So once you are clear with the raw structure of the K-map, the next step is the numbering of the binary numbers, similarly their respective variables. Now the third step is filling the number of ones or zeros by following the concept of equations. Just observing the equation, you will have to put number of ones in the equation. And then the last step, which is the most important, that is the grouping of number of ones or number of zeros. And in case of grouping, you will have to make a group of 8 cells if they are adjacent cells, 4 cells if they are adjacent cells, to make a quad, and the grouping of 2 cells which I did here to make a pair. So if there is a possibility to make an octet, then try to avoid to make a small groups, because the large group will provide more simplified or more optimized equation. So this is the general flow to solve any Boolean equation by using K-map. It will clear when we'll solve some more numericals on K-map. So now I will start the second numerical. So the next question is, a logical expression is given as follows: y is equals to summation of m 0, 1, 2, 5, 13 and 15. See, same, you will have to minimize it using K-map. See, since the first step is observe the given equation so that you can get an idea about number of variables. There might be possibility that the equation may be given in the form of variables directly, as it was given in the last question, like in the form of A, B, C, D. But the second approach, which is also used to represent the question, is like this. The first thing you will have to observe from here is summation small m. That means the equation is given in the form of SOP, because small m is always preferred for the minterm, and minterm is used for the representation of SOP form. So the equation is in the SOP form. Now what about these numbers? These numbers are simply indicating the position of the cell. So you can observe from here that 0, that means first cell having position from 0. Similarly, observe the last cell having position 15. That means you can easily make a conclusion from here that the cell will have total 16 number of, the structure will have total 16 number of cells, because the position is itself indicating from 0 to 15. So here you have 4 variables, and for the 4 variables the structure will have total 16 cells. So it will look like this. So firstly I am making simple raw structure. Fine. Now the next step is represent the variables. There is no representation of the variable, so it may be in the form of A, B, C, D, P, Q, R, S, X, Y, Z. Any variable if you want to take, you can take. But I am taking A, B, C, D for 4 variables. Now the next step is represent respective binary numbers by following the concept of gray code. Similarly, their respective variables. So it will be A bar B bar, A bar B, A B, A B bar. Similarly, C bar D bar, C bar D, C D, C D bar. This is the raw structure of the K map. Now, the next step is filling of the K map by observing the given equation. See, you can simply write, now you can simply write that the equation is like summation of these all these positions. So I may write like this: m0 plus m1 plus m2 plus m5 plus m13 plus m15. That means summation of all these positions, and the number hand here, the numbering is representing simple the position. And as you know, you remember the position of the cells. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Try to mark these numbers using pencil, because once I will fill the structure, I will erase these positions. These positions are simply going to helping us to fill these terms. Now back to the question in which I have M0, that means 1 at the position of 0. The next is 1, that means here. Now the next is 2, that means here. The next 5th, here. Next 13, and then next 15. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have total 6 terms. So the number of 1s, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the structure of K map once I filled it by following the question. Now what about the next equation? Next step, the next step is grouping of these adjacent cells if possible. So observe the structure and try to make pair or octet or quad. So no possibility of octet because it must have 8 number of adjacent cells for making a octet. What about quad? No possibility of quad because I am not able to find 4 adjacent cells to make a quad. Now what about the pair? See, these two cells can make a pair. These two cells can also make a pair. Now what about these two cells? Some students may think in this way that, ma'am, is it possible to make a pair by grouping 5th cell and 13th cell? But see, always remember one thing is mind, then whenever you will go with the pairing of the cells, then at least one member of each pair should be unique. So once you will try to make a pair of these two cells, that means this pair having two cells, this cell which is already a member of upper pair, similarly this cell which is already a member of this pair. So I will not go by making the pair for this blue pair because all the members of this pair having a part of another pair. So now I have two pairs, pair 1, this is, and pair 2. This is a wrong pairing. Why? Because both the members are already in the pairing with another group. Now what about this one and this one? Some may think in this way that, ma'am, it is possible to make a pair of these two cells, 0 and 1. If 0 and 1 is combined, then it may it is possible to make a pair. I agree, it is possible to make a pair by grouping these two cells, but if we are going with this pairing, then there is no possibility to make a pair with this one because we can directly observe that leftmost cell, that is this one, and rightmost cell, that means this one, both are always adjacent cells and it is possible to make a pair by merging these two cells because these two cells are adjacent cells. So if I avoid this concept, that is leftmost cell and rightmost cell pairing, then it is possible to make a pair by using these two cells. But in that case, whenever you will go, the simplification, the equation will not more optimized because this one will provide one term in which you will have all four the variables. So if it is possible to make a pair, then try to avoid to left single number in its own way. If it is possible, then try to make more number of pairs. So remember the concept, if I will go by making the pair by using these two cells, then there is no possibility to make a pair with this cell and the equation will not more optimized. Fine. So you can easily observe, or you can easily say that now I have three pairs, pair 1, pair 2, and by merging these two cells I have pair 3. This is the wrong pairing. So I am not mentioning, or I am not going to make a pair for this. Now the next step is elimination of the variables. So once we'll go with the elimination, we will go with step by step. What about pair 1? Pair 1 having two number of 1's. So write the expression for this one, which is A bar B C bar D bar. What about the next one? For this, the term is A bar B and C bar D. Now A bar, that means no elimination. B B, no elimination. C bar, no elimination. But D bar and D, so it can be eliminated. Now you have reduced term, that is A bar B C bar. This I get from first pair. Now what about the second pair, which is this one? Now write the expression for both the terms. For this term, the expression is A bar B C D, and for this term, the expression is A bar C D. So it is clear that A is changing from A bar to A, so it can be eliminated, while B C D is same in both the terms, so it will be B C D. Fine. Now back to pair third. Pair third, which is a pair of leftmost cell and rightmost cell. So write for this one, which is A bar B bar C bar D bar. What about this? It will be A B C bar and D bar. So see, the wrong thing is it will not A B, it will A B bar, because for the 0 I will have to write B bar, so it will be A B bar. Then the term will be A B bar C bar D bar for this one, while for this one A bar B bar C bar D bar. Now observe the variables to eliminate one variable. So you can easily observe that A bar and A will be eliminate, while the term will is B bar C bar D bar. So by grouping all the variables, you can observe that now you have three terms by making three pair. And remember one more thing, if all the number of ones are in the pair, that means you have the complete reduced equation. Suppose here you have one more number of ones, then after elimination of the variables, you will have to add one more term directly for this one. You cannot left any single variable if it is not a part of a group. If there is single one present in the structure without any pairing, then you will have to write term directly for this one. But this is not a case here. I am just giving you the clarification that how to go with this if such kind of situation you find. So now the equation will be, from pair first you have A bar B C bar, for the second pair you have B C D, and for the third pair you have B bar C bar and D bar. So this is the reduced equation of given question. So just compare the equations. In the question you have 6 terms, 1 2 3 4 5 6, while in the simplified equation you have only 3 terms. So this is the solution of such kind of question. So the next question is, a logical expression is given as follows: y is equals to summation of m. See, summation m, that means again the equation in the form of SOP. Summation m is equals to summation m for the positions 1, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. And the question is minimize it using K-map. So start the solution. The first step is, by observing the question, try to find the number of variables. So summation m, that means summation of minterms having position 1, 5th, 7, 9, 11th, 13 and 15. Since the question is itself indicating the position is starting from 1 and ending at 15, that means the structure will look like this, having 16 cells. Because the maximum position is 15, that means the structure will in the form of this. Fine. The next is representation of variable A, B, C, D. Position of the variables by following the concept of gray code 1110. Then representation of their respective variable A bar B bar, A bar B, A B, A B bar, C bar D bar, C bar D, C D, C D bar. This is the row structure. Now next, do one more thing. Mention the positions also. 0, 1, 2, 3. But try to make it by using pencil so that you can erase this. 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now back to question and try to fill number of ones by following the sequence. M1, that means here. M5, M7, M9, M11, M13 and M15. Total 7 terms, that means 7 number of ones. Fine. Now the next and most important step, that is grouping of adjacent cells. So is it possible to make an octet? No. For the octet, at least 8 number of adjacent cells should be here. Here I have only 7 cells, that is not in proper positioning to make an octet. So the next is a quad, and if it is possible to make a quad, then we will prefer C 5, 7, 13, 15. It is clear, you can clearly observe that these four adjacent cells are making quad, and I am giving the number quad 1. Similarly, for these four cells, you can say 13th, 15th, 9th and 11th, again making quad 2nd. See, in first, now in case of first quad, these two cells are unique. Similarly, in this second quad, these two cells are unique. Now, what about this single one? Think about it. Is it possible to make one more quad by merging these four cells? Because now in this quad, again, this cell is unique. And as per the concept of the grouping, at least one member of the group should be unique. And in this quad, this number is unique. So you can find this, that here you make three quads, and the interesting thing is all the terms is used in these three quads, so there is no single variable present here over now. Now the next step is elimination of the variables, and for the elimination you will have to write individual term for individual cell of each quad. Now back to quad 1. This quad 1, for this first cell, the term is A bar B C bar D. A bar B C bar D. For the next, the expression is A B C bar D. Now for this, the term is A bar B C D. And for the next, for this one, the term is A B C D. Fine. Now the same concept. See, A bar A, A bar A. So this will be eliminated. What about B? B B B B. Fine. C bar C bar C C. This will also be eliminated. What about D? D D D D. So two variables will be eliminated. Now you have only two variables remaining, that is BD. So you can draw one conclusion from here. If you are trying to making a group of pair, then only one variable will be eliminated, while in quad two variables will be eliminated, while in the case of octet three variables will be eliminated, and in the result you will get only one variable, while in quad you will get only two variables remaining because two variables will be eliminated. Now what about second quad? This second quad, write terms for each cell. For this cell, the term is A bar B C D. For this one, it is A B C D. Back to next, that is 9, cell 9, it will be A B C D bar. And what about next? It is A B C D bar. Now again observe the variables. B is same in all the terms, similarly C is also same. So A and D will be eliminated and B and C, B C is the final term from the merging. Now what about quad 3? This one, start to write from upper to lower. For this one, the term is A bar B C bar D. For the next, for this one, the term is A bar B C bar D. For this, the term is A bar B C D. And for the last, the term is A bar B C D bar. Now again observe, A bar is same, B is also same, C is changing, similarly D is also changing with terms. So the reduced term is A bar B. Now you have optimized equation having three terms only, and the equation looks like Y is equals to the term from quad 1, that is BD, plus from quad 2 it is BC, plus from third it is A bar B. So this is the optimized equation of this given question. In the question you have 7 terms, while in the optimized or in the simplified equation you have only 3 terms. So this is the more efficient method for the solution of such kind of complicated equations. So one more question. The question is itself saying a logical expression is given by this, and you will have to solve this by using KMAP. Again, before start the solution, you will have to firstly draw the raw structure of the KMAP. By following the question, you will have to observe the number of variables, since again in question the maximum position is still 15. That means you will be total 4 variables, and for the 4 variables the number of cells will be 16. So the structure will again look like this. A, B, C, D, binary numbers. Their respective variable representation: A bar B bar, A bar B, A B, A B bar, C bar D bar, C bar D, C D, C D bar. Again, the third thing is, if possible, try to mention the positions, but by using pencil. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. See, if you will clear with all the concepts and you will be able to solve the questions, then it is not necessary to mention the positions, because once you will go with more practice, it will be easy to make it in your mind that how to fill number of ones in such kind of equation. Fine. So the next is filling of number of ones, and we'll start from the position 1. That means 1, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. Total number of terms, 9 terms are here. That means I will be 9 terms in this structure, and I have actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Fine. So this is the raw structure of the KMAP. Now the next and the most important task is grouping of adjacent cells. And here you can directly easily observe that these 8 cells, 1, 3, 5, 7, 13, 15, 9, 11, 8 cells are adjacent cells and making octets. Now observe again the structure. See, here one more one is here, and this one can make a pair with this one. So all the number of ones is completed to make a grouping having one pair and one octet. Now the next step is elimination of the variable. So we will deal with this pair ones, then we will go with octet. So write terms for all the member of the pair, and in this pair the first member is this one. So for this one the term will be A bar B bar C bar D, and for the next member the term will be A bar B C bar D. Now observe the terms. You can see that B is changing similarly, but since only B is changing, A is same, C bar is also same, and D is also same. So the reduced term is A bar C bar D from the pair. Now come to octet. In octet you have 8 cells, so you will have to write 8 terms one by one. I am starting from here. For this one the term is A bar B C bar D bar. For this one the term is A B C bar D bar. For this one A bar B C bar D. For next A B C bar D. For 13th position the term is A bar B C D. For 15th it is A B C D. For 9th position the term is A bar B C D bar. And for the 11th it will be A B C D bar. So 8 terms for 8 cells. Now observe the terms and just write the variable which is not changing with terms. A bar A, A bar A, A, A. So it will be eliminated. What about B? B is same in all the terms. What about C? C is also changing. And D is also changing. So the single term you will get from here, which is B. So now instead of using this equation having 9 terms, now you have optimized equation having 2 terms only, which is A bar C bar D plus B. So this is the optimized equation of this given equation. Instead of 9 you have only 2 terms. So you can draw one conclusion from here that if you are going to make a grouping of 8 cells, that three variables will be eliminated and only one variable will be your result. Similarly in case of octet, if you have maximum 4 variables, then 2 variables will be eliminated and in the result you will have 2 variables. Similarly in case of pair of 4 variables, 3 variables will be in the result and 1 variable will be eliminated. So this is the general concept of the K-map. By using the proper sequence you can solve the numerical based on K-map and you can get your simplified Boolean equation. Now by following the concept of this approach, I am giving some questions to you. Try to solve the questions, and if you are getting any problem during solving the questions, mention your query in the comment box and try to solve these questions one by one. The logical expression is given. Solve them using K-map technique. And your question is, y is equals to summation of m 1, 3, 5, 9, 11, 13. This is the first question. The next question is, y is equals to summation of m 1, 2, 9, 10, 11, 14, 15. 1, 2, 9, 10, 11, 14, 15. And the third question is, y is equals to summation of m 0, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 13, 15. I am giving 3 questions to you. Just by following the same concept, try to solve the question, and if you are getting any problem, you can mention in the comment box. Fine. So the complete concept of the K-map is clear, I hope. Here 2 lectures I mentioned for the complete detailing of the K-map, and in this lecture I solve some numericals based on K-map. Fine. So if you are following the concept, consider to subscribe my channel by click on bell icon to get updated for the upcoming videos. Fine. Thank you.